Either we write SATIM or ZATIM, factorization. Okay. So we are starting new chapter, factorization. So till now, in four chapter, what we have studied? We have multiplied two expressions like x plus 1 or x plus 2, and we got something. Okay. So this time, for example, what will be the answer? X square plus 3x plus 2. This was the answer. We have multiplied two expressions and we have got this one. Okay, or we had the x plus 1 the whole square. X square plus 2x plus 1. Expansions we had, these all we have discussed. Okay, now we'll be, so here we have multiplied. Now we'll be taking reverse of multiplication. That is, we'll be finding the factors. Okay, what should be multiplied with what so that we may get this one. So these are nothing but these are called factors. These are called factors. Okay, so for example, if we go with the numbers, for example, I write 2. So what would be the factor of 12? If I write 12, what are the factors of 12? Forget about 1. What are the factors?
3 into 2.
3 into 4, or you may write 3 into 2 into 2. So these are the factors. You have factorized to prime factors. 3 into 2 into 2. These are the factors of 12. Okay, how you have got? So see here, if take any factor 2, if you divide 12, what you are going to get? Remainder.
6.
Remainder I'm asking.
0.
Remainder will always be 0. So by any factor you divide, the remainder is always 0. Okay. Same with these expressions. Okay. These expressions, you know, these x and y, all a and b, those variables denotes only the numbers. They as well denotes number. X is nothing but number only. It is, its value is varying, but x is a number, or we write a plus b, the whole square. Here a and b are nothing but they represent number. They represent number. So whatever we are doing with the numbers, same applies to expressions or polynomials. Same applies to them as well. Okay. So 12 you can factorize like this. If you divide 3. If you divide 12 by 3, you will get 4. But what is remainder? It means we say 3 is the factor of 12. 3 is the factor of 12. Similarly, if you divide x square plus 3x plus 2 by x plus 1, divide it. These are nothing but numbers only. If you divide them, what remainder are you going to get?
0.
0. You can check as well. It will be what? X. X into x, x square, then 1 into x plus x. What remainder are you getting here? Minus, minus, 0, 0, 3x minus x, 2x. 2x plus 2. Now, okay, plus 2 we don't use to write. X plus 2. Okay, so x into 2, 2x. 1 into 2 plus 2. What is remainder? 0. So whatever you divide, if you are dividing an expression polynomial by a factor, the remainder is always 0. So you have got both the factors. So it can be written as x plus 1, x plus 2. Okay. Either you divide this expression by x plus 2, quotient you are going to get x plus 1 and remainder will be 0. If you are dividing by x plus 1, the quotient you are going to get x plus 2, that is again another factor, and 0 will be the remainder. Same with the numbers as well. You are dividing by 3. 4 is nothing but factor of 12 and remainder is 0. This is clear. This is called factorization. So here we can express this polynomial or this expression can be expressed in the product of two smaller expressions. Two expressions we are expressing. Product of something it can be expressed. Okay. So these are nothing but these are factors. These are factors. So the question arises how to take the factors. So there are various methods of how to find the factors. There are various methods to find factors. So first method is finding the common factors. So this is applicable to all. First, we'll try to find the common factor in the expression, that is in each with each term. Okay. Okay. If I'm writing like this, 2x cube plus x. Okay. So how many terms do we have? One term, two terms,
two.
Two terms are there. So we'll try to find common among them, between them. What is common between these two terms?
X
is the common. So x taken out, 2x square plus 1. So x is a factor of this one. 2x square plus 1 is the factor of this one. It means if you divide the expression by x, 2x cube plus x, remainder you are going to get is 0. Remainder you are going to get is 0. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Remainder you are going to get 0. Yes? You keep dividing. At last you will find remainder as 0. Okay? Or you divide this expression by 2x square plus 1. The remainder you are going to get 0. Quotient will be this one. It means, so first term, first method we are taking out the common. First method is taking out the common. Okay, if it is given 3x square plus 6x plus, okay, cube we take. Cube square and 3x. Okay, what is common in all these three terms?
3 and x.
3 is common. You see here, either you can do in two steps, take 3 out, then take x out, or you can take it 3x. 3x is common in all. Now each term divided by 3x. So how much do you have here? X square here. 2x plus
x.
2x plus 1.
Okay. Plus 1. Okay. This is further factorizable. We can factorize it further. Okay, so this we will discuss afterwards, how to factorize this. Okay, no common is there, but we can factorize this as well. Okay, and this we'll discuss afterwards. Okay, that how to factorize this one now. Okay, this is clear. So first of all, always check if there is anything common in all the terms. Take that out. That is the first factor you'll get. Anything is common, always you have to check. In every expression, in every polynomial, first you have to check, is there anything common? If there is anything common, take that out, okay? This is first method, okay? For example, more than two terms are given. Okay, I'm taking one term, A, okay? I'm taking this one, AB plus BC plus AX plus CX. Here, is there anything common in all the terms? If it is, take that out. Is there anything common? Four terms we have. Is there anything common in all the four terms?
No, sir.
Nothing common in all the four terms? Okay. So when more than two terms are given, that is four even number of terms are given. So two terms, very easy. If there is common, we can take out. Now, four terms may be given. Six terms may be given. Okay. So then we have to go with grouping. You have to go with grouping first. So first method is try to find the common factor in them all. No, not there. So forget about that. Second method is we have to group them. How many terms? Four terms are there. So even number of terms are there. What you have to do? We have to group them. How to group? We have to group in pair. That is in pair of two. Is there anything common in two? Group those two which are having something common. Okay, so we can group first term. Okay, but wait a minute. We can group these two. Okay, these two as well can be grouped. These two can be grouped. These two can be grouped. This is fine. Or we can group first and third as well, second and fourth as well. So two kinds of grouping we can do. Yes or no? Okay, so if I,
yes,
I take,
yes,
we are taking the black one, that is first and second, third and fourth. They are common between them. There is common between them as well. So what is common between them?
B.
B is common. Take that out. What we have? A plus C. Okay. Plus, what is common? X.
X. A plus X. C.
Now we are having one term is here, one term is here. Two terms we have. Is there anything common between these two terms?
AC.
AC.
A plus C is common. We will take out. A plus C. From here, here, what is remaining? B plus X.
B plus X.
Yes, B plus X, okay? Okay, if we group the second way, AB plus AX, I'm rewriting it, plus BC plus CX, okay? So what is common? A?
A.
B plus X plus C, B plus X. Now see, is there something common?
B plus X.
Okay.
B plus X.
A plus X. Are they different?
No, sir. Same.
No, sir.
They are same. See here. Quadrant is commutative. Whether you write A plus C
no,
into
sir.
B plus X. Or you write B plus X into A plus C, they are same only. Is same or not? 2 into 3 is same as 3 into 2. It doesn't matter. So see here, whatever applicable to numbers are applicable to them also, because they represent at last what they represent. They represent numbers only. They represent numbers only. Understood now? Okay, do the first one.
First, so we can do the first and fourth also.
First and fourth is possible. Okay, take it. Let's see first and fourth.
No, sir, not in this case. In other case, can we
see here? You can take any two which I have in common. Okay, remaining two may as well may should have common. Okay. Okay,
yes,
which, as you practice, you will get to know these all things. Okay. Sometimes you may group, but at last you'll find there is nothing common. So you have to change your grouping as well. Such questions may be there as well. Okay. Try first one. Let's start 5A. Try first one. In grouping, mainly even number of terms will be there. When we are grouping them, always even number of terms. So check whether even number of terms are there or not. So first one is common factor only we have to find. Yes? First question. 2 into 2x minus 5y, 3x plus 4y minus 6, 2x minus 5y, x minus 5y. Okay, in this chapter there will be homework as well, okay? Because many are of the same kind. So there will be homework now onwards, okay? So this is the question. So check, is there anything common? This is our first term. This is our
x, y.
What x, y? See, here 2
minus
here, 6 here. Anything common?
2x minus 5y.
2 is common. Okay. Now see here 2x minus 5y. 2x minus 5y. This whole small expression is. So this is one factor. This is one factor. 2 is a factor. This is a factor. What will remain inside? You have taken 2, this one outside. So it will remain 3x plus 4y, 4y minus 3,
3x minus y,
x minus y, okay. Solve it, 2 into 2x minus 5y, 3x plus 4y minus 3x, minus or plus? Minus 3 into minus y, plus 3y.
Plus y.
Plus 3y, 3 into 3, 2 into 2x minus 5y, and what will be here? 3x minus 3x, 0, 4y plus 4y, 7y, okay? So you can write 14y, 2x minus 5y. Is this the answer? Check it your answer. Check it your answer.
Sir, how 3 can there in second step?
Okay.
Yes, sir.
How 3 can? Okay. So see here, what we have taken common out. This is our first term. This is our second term. Separated by minus sign. Okay. Now, what is common? 2 is common. So, 2 taken out. It means here, 3 will remain. Okay, we have taken 2 common out, 2x minus 5y. this whole we are taking out common. Okay. So from this expression, from this part, what will remain? 3x plus 4y. And from here, 2 we have already taken out. So what will remain? 3. 2 we have taken out. So 3 will remain. This already we have taken out. 3 into x minus y. Now, open the bracket. 3x minus 3x plus 3y. Now solve it within the bracket, you get 7y, and this you are getting. So see here, for this expression, what are the factors? These are all the factors. Okay. These all are the factors. Y is a factor of this one. 14 is a factor of this one. 2x minus 5y is a factor of this one. Okay. These all are the factors. Okay. Understood? So if you divide n by this, by any of these, you get remainder as 0. Okay. You can check as well afterwards. You can first solve this equation by multiplying by x, okay, and then divide them all by any of them, you'll get remainder 0. Is this clear? You are taking common out there. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Try second one now. Try second one. Everyone try second one. Everyone try second one. XY, 3X. Along with me, keep doing in your notebook. You must solve. Okay, without looking on the board, you must solve. Okay. So how you can take common out?
Sir, 3x square minus 2y square is common.
Okay. Before that, you have to make something, arrange them different. Same. Okay, see here, xy, 3x square minus 2y square. Here we have written in 2y square minus 3x square. Okay. And here, 15x square minus 10y square. Okay. So if we take 5 common out, you will get 3x square minus 2y square. So first, we'll little bit. Okay. We'll solve it little bit. So we can write xy 3x square minus 2y square. This is fine. Minus sign is there. See here, we must have it 3x square minus 2y square. If we reverse them, minus sign will become plus yz, and here I am writing 3x square minus 2y square. We can do it like this. We have taken the minus sign outside from this. So it will be minus 2y square plus 3x square. Okay. So we can write it as 3x square.
So can you again explain that why we are taking plus y?
Okay, why we are taking, okay. See here, we have to take something common out. We have to take the common out or not. This is our one term, second term, third term. We are having three terms. We have to take common out. So what could be the common? 3x square minus 2y square is common here as well. But here's here, 3x square minus 2y square. Here it is 2y square minus 3x square. So it means negative of this is here. Negative of this is here. Okay. So if you take that out, minus sign will be here. That will make plus. Or we can do one thing. First, let us solve a little bit. That is, this must be there in each term. Okay. So here we have simply written. But here, see here. It must be what? It must be this term. Here as well, we should have something like this. 3x square minus 2y square. How we can make it? By taking the negative outside. We take negative sign outside. We will have minus 2y square plus 3x square, yes, and minus will become here plus. Now we can rewrite it as 3x square minus 2y square. See the same term, same it is. Is this clear now? Okay.
So we have taken minus outside, sir. So how to become minus?
How to will become minus? Okay, if I am writing 3, it is plus 3. If I am taking minus outside, it will be like this. Yes or no? Minus minus plus 3, you will get. Okay, if I am writing 2x plus 3 and we are multiplying by minus sign, what will be inside? Minus 2x minus 3. Or if you take minus sign outside, it will be 2x plus 3. Okay, if it is 2x minus 3. Okay, take minus sign outside. If you are taking minus sign outside, it will be minus 2x plus 3. Okay, now if you open the bracket, you will see minus minus plus plus 2x minus plus minus minus 3. You are getting the same thing. Understood now? So if you are taking minus sign outside, you have to write minus 2y square. So minus minus will become plus here.
Yes, sir.
This is clear. Okay.
So now in last outside, the sign will reverse.
Yes, signs get reversed. Okay. Signs will get reversed. You can see here. We are taking minus outside. Okay. Now if you go back, minus minus will become plus. So it means you have written it correctly. Here, 3x square, we have 15x square. Here, minus 10. There is something common. 5 is common. We can take 5 outside, 5zx. What will remain inside? 3x square minus 2y square. Understood now? Now see here, we have the same thing. 3x common, 3x square minus 2y square, 3x square minus 2y square, 3x square minus 2y square. Now, in all the three terms, we can take it out. Okay? So what we are going to get? Get the answer? Everyone solve them? So what is 3x square minus 2y square? Okay, what remains? Xy plus yz plus 5zx. Okay, we can't solve it further. We can't solve this further as well. So this is our answer. This whole expression can be expressed as product of these two smaller expressions. Have you understood?
Okay. Yes.
Then try next one. Try next one. Try next one. Everyone try next one.
So this is when we can do like this, that first we group two and then the third we can take. And after that, we can include in it.
That way as well you can do. You can group these two. Okay. Then.
So first one, third.
That as well you can do. But it's fine. It's there all in all the terms. We can take ones out. Okay. We can take ones out. Okay. Try next one now. Can you see somewhere we have to take negative out? So the expression given is a square plus b square minus c square. Here, minus bc, c square minus a square minus b square plus ca, a square plus b square minus c square. Okay. Okay. Can you see something? A square plus b square minus c square. A square plus b square minus c square. Here we have common, but here c a little bit different. Yes or no? So how to proceed? So we write, okay, so first I'm writing minus a square minus b square plus c square. Okay, so I just rearrange, okay, c a a square plus b square minus c square. Here we have a square plus b square minus c square. Here as well in third term, a square plus b square minus c square. Same. But here, see here, minus a square minus, so just negative of these. Yes or no? Minus a square minus b square plus c square it is. So what should we take? Either you take this negative inside or take negative outside. That's up to you. You can do anything of them. Either you take this negative inside. So plus will be here. Here a square plus b square minus c square. Or take negative outside. Same thing is there. Yes or no? Try it. Everyone try it. Either you can say take negative inside or take this negative outside. So AB, A square plus B square minus C square. I'm taking negative inside or taking outside to become plus BC. A square plus B square minus C square plus CA, A square plus B square minus C. Now solve it. Find the common factor. Find the common factor.
A square plus B square minus C square.
A square plus b square minus c square. And what will remain? AB from there, BC and CA. This will be there. Okay. Now try fourth one. Everyone try fourth one. Everyone try fourth one. So fourth one, see here, fourth one do as homework, 2x a minus b plus 3y 5a minus 5b. So 5a minus 5b, you can take 5 outside. Similarly, third term, 4z, 2b minus 2a. 2 you can take outside, as well as minus sign as well take outside, a minus b, 2b. Then you can take the common factor. Yes or no? Fourth one, can you do? Do it now.
Yes, sir.
Are you able to get the fourth one? So after taking the common factor, it will appear like this. 2x a minus b plus 3 into 5. 15y a minus b plus taking 2 outside 8z. B minus A. See here, A minus B, A minus B, but here B minus. Take minus sign outside. So this term will be 8Z A minus B. Now take A minus B outside and you can go. Okay. Okay, now try fifth one. See here, now we are having how many terms? So expression will always contain even number of terms here. If your number of terms are there, you can start grouping them. Okay, that is 2, 6 like this, okay, here. We have to group them first. A cube plus A minus 3A square minus 3. Okay, group them. Which two you are going to group? So we have to find two terms which are having common. So which two terms are you going to take?
So starting 2 and ending 2.
So see here, as you get the expression, first check, is there anything common in all the terms? There is nothing common in all the terms. So first, forget about the first method, okay? So we'll start from method first. That is, anything common in all the terms? Not there. Forget. Now second method is, we have to group the terms, okay? How we are going to group? So first check, even number of terms are there or not? Even number of terms are there? 4 are there, okay? Now we have to group such that they are having something common. So first and
second.
Okay, first and second you are grouping, then these two will be grouped. Okay, so here a square plus 1. Here minus 3 a square plus 1. Okay, what is common? A square. Now see here, we can apply the first method. Common between these two terms. Applying first method now, a minus 3, okay? Or if you go group differently, You may have still got the answer. Yes or no? First and third, if you group, a cube minus 3a square plus a minus 3. Now, as well, you will get the answer. A square is out. A minus 3 plus a minus 3. Okay. A minus 3 outside. A square plus 1. Same answer. So, always, whenever terms are given, always check, go with the first method. Is there anything common in all the four? No. Then forget about it. Try second one. Even number of terms are there? Yes. Now, even number of terms are there? So, group the two terms. Okay. Now, again, check. First method. Is there anything common in between these two terms? Yes. Take that outside. Okay. Try second one. Okay. Try second one. Sometimes you have to expand it to solve. In second one, there that is not required. What is given? 16a plus b the whole square. 16a plus b the whole square. Minus 4a minus 4b. Okay. So, is there anything common? So, these forget these. Take this. 16. A plus B the whole square minus 4 if we take A plus B. So what is common? Okay, before this as well you can do. Okay, 1 minute. You can do it like. Okay, first check, is there anything common? 16, 4, 4. 4 is common. Take 4 outside. Okay, 4 A plus B the whole square minus A minus B. Okay, now 4 a plus b the whole square minus a plus b. Take a plus b outside. 4 a plus b, what will remain? 4 a plus b minus 1. This will be there. 4 we already have. A plus b we have taken outside. What will remain here? 4 into a plus b minus 1. It means 4 a plus b, 4 a plus 4 b minus 1. This will be the answer. Yes, sir. No? Yes.
We got minus.
Minus will be there.
Sir, in last second step, minus 1.
Minus 1. Okay. If you are taking a plus b outside, okay, if I am doing like this, 2x minus x. Okay. What is common?
X.
Okay. 2x square we take. Okay. X is common. Or else you subtract them. Okay. 2x minus x. X we are going to get. Okay. So x outside. What will remain inside? 2x minus 1 or not? Okay. If I'm writing like this, 2a plus b the whole square minus a plus b. So what is common? A plus b.
A plus b.
Here. 2 into a plus b, and here minus 1 will be there. Yes or no? You can see as well, if you multiply them, a plus b into 2a plus b, you are getting this. A plus b into minus 1, you're going to get this one. So this minus 1 is here. It's, you can do it like this. So a plus b are taking outside, 1 will be here or not? Minus 1. Minus 1 into this one. So a plus b outside, it means minus 1 will be here. Minus. Understood now?
Yes.
Have you understood? Okay. So, 7, 8.
Method also that you have started. First.
What?
So, you were doing before this method. That one can we do?
Ask again.
Said the method you are doing before it. That can we also do?
Taking out 4 out. Outside first. That one. You can take it out here. Afterwards, as well, you can take it out, is no issue. Okay. But it's easier to take it out at the first. Okay.
Yes, yes.
Okay. So try up to 8. Okay. 7th and 8th, you try. Okay. 7th and 8th, you try. We'll see the expression afterwards. Okay. So we end the meeting here. Next class, we have. Yes.
So can you once explain question number 51?
Fifth one.
So while we are grouping, so we group, we put in one column a cube plus a. Answer in another yes. column minus 3a square minus 3. So between yes. the two brackets, we have to put sign or not?
See here, a cube plus a minus 3a square plus 3. It is this, minus 3. Okay, this is here. Okay, so what is common here? A square plus 1. What is common here? Minus 3. Okay, so we are taking minus.
So before that, we have to also write now which two terms we are taking as a group.
Okay, it's fine. It's understood now. These two we are taking, these two we are taking. There's no need of mentioning these two we are taking. Okay, if you want in notebook, you can mention that. Okay, but that is not required. Okay, you must know which group you are taking. Okay, if you are taking these two, or if you are taking these two and these two, you can rewrite it like this. If you are taking first and third, you can rewrite the equation like this. Minus 3a square plus a minus 3. Okay. You can rewrite the equation this way. Now take common outside. A common. A square is common. A minus 3. Plus 1 you can take common out. Like this you can write. Yes or no? So a minus 3 outside. A square plus 1. A is 1 only. Okay. So there was no need of telling which two groups you have taken. Okay, you have rewritten the equation as this one. Now these two you are taking, these two you are taking. Okay, here these two you are taking, these two you are taking. So 3 outside, minus 3 outside, what will remain? A, and minus 3 already taken, so plus 1. A square plus 1. Okay, have you understood? Okay, so yes, we end sir. The meeting here. Okay, in next period, your notebook will be checked. Okay.